Alright, Kern, obviously, the last time we spoke, you know, was a few months ago after your debut against El Salvador, in El Salvador. This time around, you've flown in to join the team. Coming off a trial at Charleston Battery, with, you know, by all results so far, it seems to be, you know, quite positive. Tell us a bit about how that stint was.
Well, of course, it was a great experience, finally getting the chance to go out there, as any footballer would have liked to move on to a different step in their football career. The players across there, they welcomed me, and the whole environment, it was enjoyable, I must say, and the fact that I was there with other Trinidadians, Andre Tusi and Kendall Jack, they were saying we were across there as well, which made things a lot more comfortable, and hopefully, well, things would work out where I'll be able to secure a contract and move on with my career.
Alright, but obviously though, the competition there is stiff. I mean, barring the fact that you're a Caribbean player coming in there, there are guys there who have contracts with the club, but there are also others who are vying for selection. How has that competition been like? How have you been able to cope with that?
Well, across there, the training is always hard. It's a different level, so you know you always have to be at the best as consistent as possible. And the fact that I'm a foreigner, a Caribbean player as well too, coming into a different country and to a different team with players that have already established themselves, it's always hard, and you know that you have to put in that extra work and work even harder than the players that are already there. But I'm willing to put in the work, and hopefully the coach will recognize that, and if I secure a contract, maybe I could be a regular on the team.
And you should have word of that by the time the season comes around, the start of the season, within the next few weeks or so.
I'll hear things from my agent, from my sources as well too. I just hope that things will pull through, and I'm just waiting for an answer.
Alright, let's recap a bit the El Salvador game. You've had two appearances against El Salvador now. The last one was obviously more successful. You had a pretty decent game at the back. We came out successful, 1-0 winners. What are your thoughts on that particular performance?
Well, on that performance, personally, it was a good performance by myself. There's always room for improvement. But I must note that it was a great team performance, in terms of knowing that we had a very inexperienced team. A lot of the players were pretty much very young, and I think the average of the team was maybe about 20-21, which augurs well for the future of Trinidad and Tobago football.
Alright, and looking ahead to tomorrow's game, it's probably going to be the biggest international for the country. Away from home, the atmosphere is going to be different, it's going to be electrifying. We all know the Jamaicans, they bring something different to the table in terms of support. Their team is almost at full strength. We are not at full strength, barring the fact that the coaches continue to show faith in these group of players that he has here. How much you look forward to tomorrow's game, man? And it's going to take a lot out of us.
Well, it's been a dream of mine to come to play in Jamaica and to see Jamaica as well too. And getting the chance to play against Jamaica in a World Cup qualifying year is always a great opportunity to represent my country as well too. And I hope that, well, this game, knowing that will be a very big one, and the fact that we are not really up to full strength, and Jamaica has basically a full strength squad, it's going to be a hard game, but we just have to go out there, work hard, enjoy it as well too, and hopefully we could come out with a good result.
All right, good. I look forward to tomorrow's game. Thanks. All right.